Good evening, everybody. I think my time has started. I feel like I'm in a boxing ring about to be knocked out, I guess. Basically, I'm an international volleyball player first. Then I went on to play beach volleyball. Actually, I've been in many stadiums in front of large gatherings. This is my second time in front of a large gathering, in fact. But last time was very scary. This time also it's very scary, actually. I didn't want to take the mic because I didn't want you all to, you know, my hand would be shivering and my mic would be going the other side. And now I got my thing here again. I thought last time my heart was beating faster, but this time it's beating even more faster. I hope it doesn't, you know, distract you. In fact, I was also very tall in my schooling days as well. Most of you had asked my height. Everybody would be curious to know my height, I guess. I am 6 feet 4 inches tall. I think all your doubts would have been erased now. 194 centimeters. In centimeters, I was telling. Back in school as well, I was the tallest in my class. In my school itself, not this class. And wherever I go, if somebody does any mischief, if I'm in that gang, I always used to get caught. And all the teachers were all behind me always, for a good way, in good ways and bad ways as well. So whenever I used to get caught, or if somebody else does something and I used to get caught, and they used to come and, you know, try to punish me. But I'm very tall and I'm very fortunate at that time. But then they wouldn't even leave me. They would always come near me and ask. They would climb on top of the bench and then they'll try to scold me. They would be at par with me only then. So it was really fun. And I even remember days in my schooling when we used to have the group photographs. So always my head was chopped off. So I decided never to go in for any group photographs from then on. And I was a very, very quick, very energetic person when I was in school. I didn't know what to do. I'd be running here and there, very busy with something or the other. So my school teacher, who was a physical education teacher, who really spotted me and channelized me into this game of volleyball. But like every other kid, everybody likes cricket. Even I used to like cricket then, and I also wanted to become a cricket player like anybody else. Maybe I would have become a star in cricket if not for my physical education teacher. But he said, you choose a different game because you've got the height for it. You've got the physique for a good volleyball player, and he channelized me into the game of volleyball. So I took up volleyball only at 11th standard. It's very late, in fact, because in Tamil Nadu and all around India, we have many sports schools which start to hone talent at a very young age. 6th standard, 7th standard, there are many top players in India who have started very young. But I started a bit late. This game, the game of volleyball, which is not very easy to learn. It's got many, very many techniques. We have to have good jump, coordination, technique, and things like that. And I went on to represent my school team, started to win many. You can see the photo. That's me. And you know, I used to be like this. இப்படி இருந்தனா இப்படி ஆயிட்டேன். அதுக்கப்புறம் வாலிபால் விளையாண்டதுக்கப்புறம் ஒன்ஸ் ஐ ஸ்டார்டட் பிளேயிங் ஐ ஹேட் அ குட் வென்ட் டு த ஜிம் அண்ட் திங்ஸ் லைக் தட். அண்ட் இப்போ இப்படி இருக்கேன்னு கேட்டிங்கன்னா கொஞ்சம் ஒன்றெலாம் பார்த்து பயந்து போய் திரும்ப இப்படி ஆகிட்டேன். ஸோ அது ஸோ யூனோ வென்ட் ஆன் டு வின் மெனி டோர்னமெண்ட்ஸ் ஃபார் மை ஸ்கூல் அண்ட் பிகேம் வெரி ஃபேமஸ் இன் மை ஸ்கூல். அண்ட் இவன் நவ் இஃப் ஐ கோ அரவுண்ட் சம்வேர் மேபி 10-15 இயர்ஸ் ஆஃப்டர் ஐ ஃபினிஷ் மை ஸ்கூல், இஃப் ஐ கோ அரவுண்ட் எனிவேர், பீப்புள் சடன்லி கம் டுவர்ட்ஸ் மீ அண்ட் ஆஸ்க் மீ, ஹே ஜான், ஹவ் ஆர் யூ? அண்ட் I wouldn't know who they are, but they will be telling, I studied with you in school, you were in 12th, I was in 6th standard. Oh yeah, how would I even know them? But oh, Abdiya, okay, fine and all. So even now, after 10-15 years, after my schooling, people do come to me very often, not once in a while, very often people, schoolmates who had studied with me, were very, they are juniors to me, they used to come and talk to me. Then after school, what happened, I was a star in school and everybody came to know me. My teachers helped me to make up all the lessons which I hadn't finished and things like that. My friends helped me and I was a big success in school, even if not the number one in studies, maybe I was an above average student. Then after school, I really wanted to take up volleyball as my profession, like all other our parents, everybody, my father was telling, நீ உருப்படாமல் போயிரப் போகிறாய் விளையாண்டு அப்படின்னு. But then I thought, no, we'll try to play volleyball. He wanted me to join engineering, but I was very fortunate. I got a BSc physics seat. The physical education teacher from Loyola gave me a free seat in BSc physics. But those days back, I'm not very fortunate. Like the situation now, it's very different. Now all the engineering colleges give free seat plus stipend for all top athletes. Not volleyball, all the top athletes, they give free seat. I don't want to name the names of the colleges. They give you free seat, no fees, plus they give you stipend per month to play for the college. So back then it was not there, but the best I could get about 10-15 years back was a seat at BSc Physics in Loyola, which was a big thing then. But at the same time, I also got, I was called for a selection trials in the Indian junior team, which was to take part at the Asian Championship, which was to qualify for the World Championship. So I was one among the 24 probables selected for the Indian junior team. This was in 1994, long time ago. And I was really happy that I got selected into the team. But then I also had to sacrifice many things because I had to leave my family, friends and all the things because I've never been away from my house. And for 2 years, from 1994 to 96, I was in Bangalore under a very tough coach. It was a very tough period for me, especially leaving my family and friends and everybody. You know, the coach was very tough. If you make mistakes, you'll get whacked like anything because we were all like soldiers. Then only I realized that we are all soldiers. We are preparing for a battle to get name for ourselves as well as for our country in the international arena to get a good name for the volleyball also. So there I learned about dedication, discipline, motivation, team spirit and team building. Team spirit became very important because all of us had a common goal to achieve something. So it was more like MBA, you know, when there was a manager, there was a coach and there was a captain. So all the leadership qualities, everything came up once we were there in team because we were there for 2 years. This was the family now. I had left my house and I've come to another family member. So then on in the Indian junior team, I had a chance to represent the country, to play for our country at a tournament at Dubai, and I was very excited like any other guy who was, you know, about 17, 18 years then, to represent the country first thing, to travel by plane. Third was to see a foreign country, and I was all excited, and all the team members, we were about to board the flight and we got the boarding passes and things like that. And all of a sudden, one guy in the walkie-talkie comes in and says, hey, is this the Indian bound team to Dubai? And my coach said, yes, this is it. And he said, please, you'll have to come out. The match has been cancelled. You got a message. Please get back. I thought, oh, I was very lucky, you know, making it big at a young age and things like that. And all of a sudden, everybody started to look at me, all my teammates, because they had already gone for a tournament about a month back to another place. And I was the only man out who was not in the team. So everybody started to have doubts. Oh, is this the guy? He's the iron feet. I think he's got the iron feet. He's the odd man out, black sheep kind of things. And I was like, okay, fine. I didn't give up hope. I fought still harder and again made it to the team again. But before that, again, I was dropped out of the team because of certain reasons. And the team went for the Asian Championship. They came second place at the Asian Championship at Qatar, but they did not manage to qualify for the World Championship, Junior World Championship. Then I got another break. I was selected for the Indian junior team. We had to play in the Junior World Qualification Tournament at China. I was again included into the team. I was given another chance. And God willing, we performed very well. And we won the gold medal as well as the cup and also qualified for the Junior World Championship, which was after a gap of about 28 years. So it was a great achievement. I was really happy. From then on, there was no looking back. There were many tournaments, many trophies that we won, and we had very good publicity, and you know, people welcomed us. Once we were there in the airport, they welcomed us. Next. It was really nice, so much of attention and things like that, but you know, a sportsman, if you're a sportsman, you're bound to get injured. So I had a very major injury in my right knee. I had torn my ligament. And I tried to play with my torn ligament, but it didn't help. I got my knee twisted again and again, again and again. And I had to go to the doctors, and you know, they said you have to get operated upon, and you have to have a ACL replaced, anterior cruciate ligament replaced, and also your cartilage is damaged. So it will take about a year for you to, you know, play again. Just to play again, it will take about a year. So I was really down and frustrated. I didn't know what to do. I thought the whole thing is over and I cannot come back to play. Because once you're out of your team, there are 100 people waiting to get that place. If I'm out, there are 100 people to get my place. So again, after 1 year, I'll have to get back to my best and fight back my position. Was not an easy thing, but my determination was very strong. I thought, okay, no, I should not give up. I fought back hard, started working out and everything, building my muscles even more. Then for a rehab, I started playing beach volleyball. That's how I got into beach volleyball. That's me at the Asian Games in Qatar in Doha 2006. It's not somebody else, it's me jumping. So the basic thing is the sand was very soft. So I started playing beach volleyball as a rehab for recovery for my knee surgery. So once that happened, my love towards the game started really pulling me to. Even though I was there in the state team, I captained the Tamil Nadu state team. That was the next step to go to the Indian team again, Indian volleyball team. But then I started to like beach volleyball even more because, you know, so many beautiful girls, I guess. I was some other speaker who wouldn't show us all the photos, so now I'm showing mine with the girls. And there are good looking guys also coming a little later, so for the girls. So once I'm talking about beach volleyball, everybody would be thinking, what is beach volleyball? You know, only if beach volleyball, only in the mind, you know, everybody's mind will be like girls playing in bikini and things like that. Well, that's one part of it, but it's not really bikini, but that's what we have all got a prejudice about beach volleyball. It's not like that. It's a very tough game. Only two players in a side, whereas volleyball, there are 6-on-6 plus 6 substitutes for a team. Whereas this got only two players, and it has to have good understanding with your partner. If your partner is not well or you're not well, there are no substitutes. You have to play in the sun, rain, any condition, wind, nothing. You have to continue your game. You need to play two games or three games in a day at an international competition, whereas the indoor volleyball is played under AC conditions like similar to these. So I thought that is more challenging and more glamorous as well. We can have glasses and things like that. So I thought, okay, fine, let me shift into beach volleyball. And of course, all these also are added advantages to that. There are good looking guys as well. So one of them is, I'm also there. So this is the general beach volleyball ground wherein you have tape and, you know, two players this side, two players that side. So that's how it all started. From then on, after I started playing beach volleyball, my representation, I won almost all the titles that India ever has. I won all the titles, state, the national, national games. These are certain matches we are playing against China. We defeated this Chinese team which won the silver medal in the Asian Games. But we were very unfortunate that the people here didn't send us for the Asian Games in 2010 in China. And okay, I'll come back to that. I mean, there is politics everywhere, but then we'll have to, you know, overcome it. Against all odds, we'll have to survive. Maybe if not this time, maybe sometime we'll get our chance and we will succeed. So this is at the opening ceremony of the Lusifonia Games. So, and this is my partner. We won almost all the trophies. This is an international tournament at Bangladesh, the Asian level tournament. We won the tournament. So almost beach volleyball, I achieved more in beach volleyball than what I achieved in volleyball. So it was a good break for me. It was like a blessing in disguise. The injury which I had was a blessing in disguise. I took it as a challenge. When my one main door was closed, the other door opened and I capitalized on it and did well in beach volleyball, winning almost all the major tournaments, as I said earlier. And now, I'm in the lag end of my career. I still wouldn't want to quit. But I've started a club called the Chennai Spikers Volleyball Club, basically there's no politics. We just want to promote youngsters who play volleyball and also high-end professionals. We want to support them because in beach volleyball, what happens? We do not have sponsors. We find it very hard even to play for the country at an international level. So just for that, we have started a club so that we would be able to help the future players, budding players from India to play for the country at international levels, because India has got very good potential to win a medal at the Asian Games as well as the Olympics. But we don't recognize it. We just turn a deaf ear to sports As earlier they said, there was music, curriculum in music. Sports also is very important for us. And as I told you very earlier, I have got a job in State Bank of India. Now I am an officer in State Bank of India. They were also giving some pamphlets about State Bank. I think they are one of the sponsors, right? Okay. So I work in State Bank of India at Anna Salai in the housing loan cell and also the education loan. So if you have any this thing, you can also contact me. just kidding. So that's how my sporting career is. The club which you have started is basically to promote youngsters, and because of beach volleyball, I got a chance to visit so many countries. Indonesia, I know about 25-30 countries. I was able to play at and various exotic beaches and to enjoy so many things. So I encourage all of you to again, ipidi na ipidi item parunga. This is my team, Indian team, which we played. This is in Brazil at the Copacabana beach. This, of course, Eiffel Tower, you don't want to. And this is again Brazil by the River Thames. Jai Hind. Thank you all.